The question was, how do I not fall back in my spiritual path? That question came after listening to the story of Jadabharata in Bhagavatam. First, let us stop worrying about fallback. Let us not waste our time in what can happen. Let us focus our time on what I can do, what I should do every day. In every day, we have only 24 hours available to us. Just 24 hours. We get one day at a time. That 24 hours we have to utilize properly. If I get up tomorrow, that 24 hours, God gives one more 24 hours, that's a bonus. But He has given 24 hours today. How do I utilize that 24 hours? Am I using it properly? So the 24 hours we have to divide into three. My work, God's work, and self-realization. My work is what I do for my earning my livelihood, my personal work, for my family, what is required for my sustenance and survival. Some part of the day will go for that. Then God's work is what I can do as a service to this society. That's God's work. And that's called Yajna. And then for my self-realization, what I do is spending time for myself on my own realization. So this, my work, my personal work is required for survival, sustenance, which we cannot do, which we cannot do away. At any point of time, we have to do that. So suppose you are working in a company and a job, probably the job is so demanding, you may work for 18 hours or 14 hours. The remaining time you have to utilize properly for God's work and self-realization. So as you are able to progress in your life, probably you may need less time to work for survival and you may have more time for God's work and self-realization. That you have to balance properly. The God's work is called Yajna. It's a service or an offering what you can do to the society. And that is called Jagadithaya. And what is your work? What is your self-realization? Atmano Mokshartham. So Atmano Mokshartham Jagadithaya is what you have to think. How much time I can utilize and how efficiently I can utilize. Atmano Mokshartham. For my self-realization, what I have to do? The only thing you have to do is Shravana Manana Nididhyasa. This process should be ongoing process. Shravana Manana Nididhyasa. This you have to spend some time every day. It's a continuous process. Don't evaluate where I am progressing, how much I am progressing. If you are focus your attention on doing, focus your attention on Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa as efficiently, as well, as focused way as possible. That's the best you can do in any day. So what will the result come? When will the result come? Don't worry about that. If you do it every day properly, that result will accumulate. It's like a cumulative interest. You have heard of this cumulative interest? You put say one rupee a day. That 1 rupee next day it will add interest. So the cumulative interest will grow exponentially as you add up. Every small step a day will grow into a large thing. It will grow exponentially because the cumulative interest, what you did yesterday will add today. So you do Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa every day and try to improve next day. Don't worry about the end result. Every day you improve on what you learnt, what you did yesterday, and improve on that. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. This is called Atmano Mokshartham. For Atmano Mokshartham, what you can do? You can only do this. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Okay. Out of the Shravana or listening is Guru's grace. The grace of Guru, the teaching. Manana Nididhyasa is your grace. How you apply the teaching in your life is called Manana Nididhyasa. And Shravana is what you do. It is the teaching of Guru. It's Guru's grace. So both you apply it in your life every day. How much time you spend, you can think on that. Then comes Jagadhitaya. The service to the world. We keep taking from the society. We have to give back to the society. Okay. So that is called Jagadhita. And Jagat is the world. So now there are so many things happening in the world. Right? Okay. So many good things and bad things are happening. And we keep worrying about bad things. And we keep on listening to bad news and worry. So don't worry what is happening in the world. To run the world efficiently is the God's job. And He knows how to do His job. The question is, do you know your job? How to do? You have a job in God's work. The God is running the whole world and society. What is that your contribution to that is your job. You have to do it efficiently every day. So this is called Yajna or it's called Jagadhitayacha. Now what is Yajna you have to understand properly. Yajna is what you give back. You can give back only what you have earned. You cannot give back what you don't have. So you have to earn and you have to give back. You have to earn, you have to give back. So if you earn money, you can give back to the society what you earn in terms of money. Right? So the Yajna is a process by which what you give will grow over a period of time. Suppose somebody wants to do Dhana Yajna. He wants to give money to the society, help poor. Then, if he has to give 1 rupee, he has to earn 100 rupees. If he has to give 10 rupees, he has to earn 1000 rupees. So like that, you earn more and give more. Earn more, give more. So in the process, you grow. Yajna is not a process of giving. Yajna is a process of growing yourself. Please understand, Yajna is not giving. It's not a charity. Yajna is a process by which you give and grow. By giving, you grow. What you give, you grow. The principle of nature is what you give to the God, you will get back in abundance. That is Yajna. Now, you have to be very clear what you want to get from God in abundance. Okay? So, that you have to give. So, suppose you are interested in money, then you start learning how to do a small part of your work as Yajna. Now, Yajna earning, you have to do as Yajna. So, Yajna don't confuse with charity. The charity is, or Dana. Dana is, you give something and forget it. Okay? Let us say some person is struggling, you give some 10 rupees and forget it. Right? It is giving a food to somebody who is hungry. Dana. But Yajna is different. Yajna is, you are not giving food, you are helping him to grow food. You are not giving him fish, but you are teaching how to fish. So, in the process of how to teach him fish, you will also learn better and you also earn start, your growth happens. So, we have to do Yajna. Yajna means give to grow. That is Yajna. Give and forget is called Dana. Dana. So, Dana is not I am speaking of. Yajna is what is called Loka Kalyana. The moment you start doing Loka Kalyana, you grow in that area. That's the principal nature. That's what is called grace by God. We already speak of grace, 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 giving grace, giving grace. Grace is there, but you are not receiving it because you don't know how to give. Please understand that. The grace of God is there in the form of sunlight and rain. But you need to know how to receive it. You have to plant seeds in the ground, wait for rain and sunshine will come. The grace is there. Are you utilizing it? So to utilize it, you have to do your work. That's called yadna. You need to know how to give back as a part of God's work. You should become a co-creator in the God's creation. That's called yadna. Once you start doing yadna, what you give will start growing. Please understand there's a difference between dana and yadna. Dana is giving. Dana is like giving fish. Somebody is hungry. Yadna is like teaching somebody who to do fishing. Okay. In the process of teaching, you grow. So the principle is what you teach, you learn better. So that's why this what my guru taught me. That's what I learned in my life. I want to grow in jnana. I want to realize myself. So then I have to participate in jnana yadna. Jnana yadna is service activity where jnana of in the form of self-realization is given to the society. That's called jnana yadna, or it's called rishi yadna. Rishi yadna is the highest yadna, where jnana received from the guru, rishi, is distributed to the society. So in the process, what will happen? You receive from your guru, your master, rishis, and you give it to society. So when you give it to society, you are not doing dana, charity. The society grows in that. Society, wisdom grows in the society. And the wisdom grows in society, the wisdom in you grows. You grow. So by participating in rishi yadna, your awareness, your jnana, your self-awareness grows. So yadna is an important part, or jagaditaya is an important part of our life. So what yadna you have to do, you have to decide. You want money, you do dana yadna. Okay? You want to jnana, you want to do jnana yadna. You have to participate in jnana yadna. So jnana yadna participation, how is the process? You receive from rishis, you receive from guru, and you distribute to society. You pass it on, participate in the process of jnana yadna. That's jnana yadna. And jnana yadna immensely purifies you. Okay? That purification is called grace of God. So Bhagavan. So that's what we receive. So I told two aspects. One is what we do for our own work, for our survival. That you do as your duty. That you do as karma yoga. Duty to your wife, due to your family, due to the job, due to the company. Then you do yadna as an offering to God. That's called God's work. So as you do God's work, the grace will start flowing in abundance. What you give will grow. So that will help you in atmano mokshartam. That means you are on meditation. Shravana, manana, nididhyasa will strengthen. Your jnana, your awareness increases. That awareness, shravana, manana, nididhyasa, again you are putting in the jnana yadna. So it's a self-reinforcing process. Atmano mokshartam jagadidaya. It's a positive feedback. They feed one each other. But then if you take service in one area and self-realization in another area, that may not match. Okay. So you may say that I will do some activity. Let's say I'll give charity and I'll do meditation. Okay, if you have a lot of money, you can do it. But what I'm saying is the intelligence is aligning. The intelligent way of living is aligning our yadna with atmano mokshartam, yadna which is jagaditaya cha, with atmano mokshartam, self-realization. Atmano mokshartam jagaditaya, you have to align. We have to participate in jnana yadna and we have to do shravana, manana, nididhyasa. So that's how feed, there's a self-positive reinforcement which happens in this process. So now if you are able to spend this time efficiently in all these three for your own work, right? For your own survival, what is? And then yadna, and then meditation, shravana, manana, nididhyasa. Where is the time for you to worry and where is the time to fall back? You have to do all these three efficiently as karma yoga without worrying about the result. You have to focus on how to do it well. The result you have to give to God. Result you have to, God will give in the form of grace. He will give in abundance. Don't worry about what you get. Focus on what you do, what you can do every day efficiently. And don't align your life very properly. Don't, see, we should not dig too many wells. We should dig one well deep. Digging well removes, keeps on removing the mud. Don't ask when is the water reached, because you don't know when will the water reach, when will you reach the water. Digging the well is your responsibility. Giving the water is God's responsibility. The water is God's grace. Your duty. Your duty has two parts. One part to your family, yourself, and other part is to the society. That's called yadna. And other part is for self-realization. Atmano mokshartam jagaditaya and survival. These we have to align our time very efficiently. In my own life, this is what I learned from my guru, my master, and this is what I applied in my life. When I was working in the working professionally, I was working very hard. It is very time consuming, very intense, and I work very hard, and I did my work as a karma yoga, as a duty to my family, duty to my society, I did it. That became karma yoga. I spent 12 to 14 hours a day. Then 1 or 2 hours a day, I was using for spending on meditation. And the traveling time, when I go to office, I used to study for scriptures. So that's how I used my life, working life efficiently. So because I worked hard, I got a promotion, I progressed in my career. And at a point of time came where I don't need to work for myself. Whatever savings I had sufficient for my survival. So then I started during that period when I was working, I used to spend time in participating in doing Jnana Yadna by conducting weekend classes to the students. And this I have been doing for several years, and each it keeps on growing. It's like your money which you invest. So if you keep on investing the money, it will grow in a compounded way. So that will start growing. The service which I started doing started growing. It started helping people. And that help started giving a positive feedback to me. Yadna, Jnana Yadna, which I used to do, that helped my own meditation, my own manana and nididhyasa. So what you give grows. So more and more I was able to spend as my professional responsibility started coming down, my family responsibility started coming down. I was able to spend more time on Jnana Yadna by teaching people and Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. This is a continuous activity. Atmanam Mokshatam Jagaditaya. So, if you keep doing this, you will not worry. And use your 24 hours very efficiently. At the end of the day, you thank God. Offer that 24 hours to God, saying that, God, whatever you have given me time, I have used it properly. If you are done that day is meaningful. And if the day is meaningful, today is meaningful, tomorrow is meaningful. If tomorrow is meaningful, day after tomorrow is meaningful. So live your life meaningfully every day. Keep improving what you do every day. Every small step will take you towards a larger goal. And don't expect larger goal. What happens is God's will. What you do is your sadhana, your yadna. Focus on your yadna and sadhana. The God's grace will flow in abundance. It will shower you. It will shower on you. It will rain on you. Then you will be carried away by that grace. Make yourself recipient of that grace by utilizing that 24 hours you have today very efficiently every day. Atmano Mokshartam Jagaditayacha. That's the answer to your question.